Northeast, welcome to Gainesville, and welcome to the SEC on ESPN. Inside the O'Connell Center, where Florida's won 24 straight games and ranked number 7 in the early season. They welcome in Georgia, one of 4 remaining unbeaten in SEC play, through with a week. This is all part of my home court week, and this is one of the great home court advantages in all of college basketball. We're walking right inside of it. Former ACC coach Dino Gaudio, Joe Davis. A couple of 2-0 teams, one that everybody expected in Florida, and then the other in Georgia. I don't think anybody really expected to be 2-0 through the week.
No, I think we have the best team in the SEC tonight in Florida, and the team that just surprised everybody in Georgia, who last week was at the event, number 21 Missouri, took off a monumental upset. And in Florida, you have a team that's faced adversity, suspensions, and injuries. And Billy Donovan somehow has his team at number 7 in America.
Pretty fun in here, isn't it?
These students been here 2 hours before game time.
You're a former coach, so for our one-on-one, let's look at a little bit of X's and O's.
Multiple ball screens tonight we're going to see out of Florida. And what Florida's guards want to do, they want to get deep into the lane. As we watch Scotty Wilbekin against Arkansas right here, his penetration draws 5 defenders, which creates the wide open 3 for Dorian Finney-Smith. A huge basket in overtime for Florida. Now on the other side, Georgia, they have to guard ball screens. Watch the job they do on Alabama's Trevor Relaford. He won't get into the lane. The Georgia bigs stretch him out, keep him out of the lane, surround him. Joe, the team that controls the ball screen aspect side of this game will be a major factor in winning it.
Here's the first 5 that will try to do that for Georgia. Charles Mann, the SEC Player of the Week, had 40 points in the 2 games last week. Gaines had a career-high 22 on Saturday, but look inside with Morrison Williams. Mark Fox wants more scoring out of both of those guys. For 7th-ranked Florida, this is the 7 different starting lineup they've had. Patrick Young back into the starting 5 after coming off of the bench on Saturday at Arkansas. But once again, without their leading scorer, Casey Prather. 2nd straight game missing with a knee. He's day-to-day at this point. They'll reevaluate him going into Saturday's game at Auburn. 208th all-time meeting between these teams. Georgia trying to do what they did against Missouri, that is snap a long streak. Florida's won 24 in a row here. 3rd longest in the nation behind Stephen F. Austin and Duke, which extended its streak last night. Officials for today's game, Tony Green, Ted Valentine, and Rick Hartzell. So Georgia wins the tip off to a 2-0 start in SEC play for the first time in more than a decade.
Now, Georgia's going to want to run the shot clock down into single digits in an effort to slow the basketball game down.
Here's Dante Williams.
As we talked about, Joe, short clock under 10 right now for Georgia.
Gaines an open look. In and out. And tipped into the hands of Yegette. He's Florida now, looking for his 7th consecutive win. What would be a score record 25th straight win here in the O-Dog.
And with the injury to Prather, you're seeing Casey Hill go to the 1 and Wilbekin go to the 2. Let's see how Florida handles that adjustment offensively.
Will Yegette shuffled his feet. That's the first Florida turnover. Mark Fox celebrated his 45th birthday yesterday. His 5th season as head coach at Georgia. Took over the program in 2009 after 5 years as head coach at Nevada. Georgia able to break some backcourt pressure.
Now, if you're Georgia, when you see pressure, you want to think layups and dunks. You want to attack it. And if you don't have it, we're going to run good half-court offense.
Morris inside for the first bucket of the game. Brandon Morris, a guy that Mark Fox says has some potential to be more of a scorer. Averages about 9 a game. He'd like to see him around a dozen in the scoring column.
And one of the things Georgia does offensively, Joe, they run a basic offense, is what they call it. And the first option is the flex cut, which we saw right there for the layup. Flex cut is that baseline cut along the block.
Young bounces into traffic, and Casey Hill off the back iron. Last touch by Georgia. Florida's way. Coached by Billy Donovan. Who would have thought there'd be a day when Billy the Kid was the dean of the SEC? 18th season now.
It's amazing. And I walk into practice yesterday, and his son there looks exactly like Billy and shoots the ball exactly like Billy did when he was at Providence.
Florida coming off that 84-82 win in overtime at Arkansas on Saturday. A game that was seven ties and 13 lead changes. And another really hard place to play in Bud Walton Arena. You get the senior out of France. That's the score.
And that's one way we talked about at the top about how Florida scores off their ball screen offense. The roll, the pass to you get, and the finish.
Mann gets out of the press for the Bulldogs, and now Gaines inside.
And I like Georgia. They attacked it, realized they didn't have anything. Now let's pull it out and run good half-court offense.
Against one of the best defensive teams in the country. Mark Fox said today he thinks Florida's defense is underrated.
They're one of the top 10 in the country. Yeah. I don't know how it can be.
Shot clock winding down. Mann inside to Thornton, who's got his first two. Marcus Thornton at 9 points, 8 boards, 5 blocks in the win against Alabama on Saturday. Patrick Young gets rejected by Thornton. His first block of this one.
Now, Thornton picked up right where he left off in their last game against Alabama. He blocked 5 shots and altered several others. First block inside the first 3 minutes of the game for Marcus Thornton.
Hill is open off of the inbound play, but they'll set up the offense. Really, 2 point guards on the floor with Wilbekin and the freshman Hill.
And you see Georgia on a baseline out of bounds play 2-3 zone, and that's what they're in right now.
Skip pass to the SEC's top 3-point shooter, Michael Frazier. Gaines went baseline, fired one off at Thornton's hands. Hill knocks it out of bounds. Last touch by Georgia.
Teddy Valentine with the call.
At one time,
my old nemesis, but I love Teddy now. First technical I ever received, JV basketball. Teddy's calling the game in Wheeling, West by God, Virginia.
What'd you do?
Nothing. You can't say anything to Ted.
Wasn't a magic word.
I just standing there. He didn't like the way I looked. He said he parted my hair on the wrong side.
Frazier with a nice up fake to get Gaines to fly by.
When Frazier puts that aspect of his game in there, the shot fake and the drive to the basket, very difficult to cover.
Morris does well to catch that high pass from Mann. Now Georgia sets up. They've been better on the offensive end this year, despite being without the SEC Player of the Year, Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, who was drafted by the Pistons, or by committee this year. The offensive numbers up.
And we're down under 10 on the shot clock again, John.
Mann off the back iron with a long three. You get with a rebound. But a loose ball taken by Morris, and he scores to put Georgia back in front.
Never save the ball under the other team's basket.
Scotty Wilbekin sent the game into overtime on Saturday with an 8-footer with just 2 seconds left. He was questionable in that game with an ankle injury. Wound up playing 34 minutes and tying a career high with 34. Thornton tried to thunder it down, but Young deterred. And here comes Florida.
Because Florida's not a great three-point shooting team, despite this guy right here, Georgia's going under all handoffs and ball screens.
Want to go over the screen, though, against Frazier.
You absolutely do, because you want to chase him off of the three-point line.
That was one of the big focuses during the shoot-around today for Mark Fox. Casey Hill steps in front of the pass, and the McDonald's All-American gets rejected by Kenny Gaines. What a job by the sophomore out of Atlanta to get back and keep it a 6-6 game in the early going.
Okay, when I talked to the Alabama staff, they were surprised how athletic Georgia was defensively. And there's the two guard blocking a shot.
All tied up in a battle between two 2-0 teams in SEC play. ESPNU's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by the Quicksilver Card from Capital One. Earn 1.5% cash back on every purchase. Florida's won 24 straight in this building. Last time they did that, the only other time they did that in school history, the back-to-back championship seasons of 06 and 07. With Dino Gaudio, Joe Davis back inside on Saturday. They went up to another great place in Bud Walton Arena. Scotty Wilbekin, after Florida was down 7 with under 5, banked one in with 2 seconds to go to get that game into overtime. He had 10 of his 18, which matched a career high in the OT. And Dorian Finney-Smith, the career best game, 22-15. Florida wins it in overtime, 84-82. That's a big-time win on the road. Billy Donovan says Arkansas is a top-10 team when they're at home.
Arkansas, last year, as we know, frazzled Florida in a beatdown at Arkansas. But I talked to Melvin Watkins, the assistant at Arkansas, and he said we could not frazzle this team right here. They kept their composure, a great win at Arkansas. Like our colleague Jimmy Dyke says, in that arena, Bud Walton Arena, Arkansas is a top 10 team.
Out of the inbound, a couple of subs for Florida. Here is Dorian Finney-Smith, 22 points and 15 boards on Saturday. Look at Frazier flying in for the rebound. And a fresh shot clock for the Gators. Wilbekin goes by Morris and finds Frazier for three.
I watched practice yesterday, Joe. They stretch and they spend an hour on defense. And Frazier never missed a shot. My point being, he never even warmed up. They did no shooting drills. He never missed a shot in the first hour of practice.
We're here for the shoot-around today. We left about 20 minutes after. He was still shooting.
Shooters love to be in the gym, and that's what he does.
Foul that was on Devon Walker, fresh into the game. Nearly a steal for Frazier. Now Gaines fires it out of bounds off of the hands of Williams. A big story for Georgia this season has been rebounding. They've won the 8 games that they've won the battle on the boards. They've lost the 5 that they've lost the rebounding battle. They tied in the loss as well as far as rebounds go.
You talk to Mark Fox, he says Kentavious Caldwell-Pope is a great scorer for us, but he was also a leading rebounder. And when we learned to gang rebound, that's when we got better as a basketball team.
He was really tough on his group early on about the defense and the rebound. Young bullies the smaller defender and scores with the left hand.
Bully is a great word because he big boyed him right there.
Looks like a football player, 6'9", 240. Senior out of Jacksonville, 3-year starter for this Gators team. Morris is open. Here's Wilbekin. Finney-Smith.
Dorian Finney-Smith was spectacular at Arkansas, and he just picks up right where he left off. He's the one big guy, Joe, that can spread the defense with threes.
Juricic with a screen for Mann, who curls inside and gets blocked by Walker. Wilbekin with a 1-on-2. Might have gotten away with the travel.
He did get away with the travel.
Finney-Smith will shoot 2. So much more confident over the last couple of games, this sophomore transfer out of Virginia Tech.
And this is what this kid does. Like Eric Murphy last year, a big that can spread the floor because he can make threes, and a wonderful block from the Gators.
Since 1980, in the Sunshine State, the building they call the O-Dome has meant basketball, where the rowdy reptiles gather to pay tribute to their Gators.
It was built in 1980 for $15.5 million. Seats more than 11,000 here at the O'Connell Center, named after the school's sixth president, served in the mid-60s into the mid-70s. Actually, the floor here at the O'Connell Center right now is from the 2006 Final Four in Indianapolis. They sanded it down and put their own logo and colors on it. And it is Patrick Young Beard Giveaway Night. That's a good look.
This is all right for me. I'll get a text from my wife whether she likes it or not.
I'm seeing this in the monitor here.
When in Rome?
I guess.
When in Rome?
I guess. So Patrick Young's got this beard, and the students' first 1,000 that came out today got one. And those 1,000 students were here 2 hours before the game. It's a little more difficult to get off wearing a headset on. I might just do this segment here with the beard on. There is Patrick Young, really well-liked kid. Two-time SEC Scholar Athlete of the Year. Making his 84th career start today out of those 127 games that he's played in a Florida uniform.
Patrick Young, a telecommunications major. He interned this summer at a TV station in Jacksonville, and probably, Joe, shortly he'll be sitting here with us broadcasting games. Yeah. Hopefully he has a longer playing career, but whether it's in Europe or in the NBA, but a wonderful, wonderful young man.
Dorian Finney-Smith at the stripe with a couple of shots after getting fouled before the whistle. An 0 of 2 for Finney-Smith. Well, the one thing anytime anybody comes here, the coaches always talk about, is being able to withstand that Florida pressure. And when they go on runs and this crowd gets going, it makes it tough.
They're talking about whether it was a backcourt violation or not. And Ted Valentine is right. The inadvertent whistle. To be a backcourt, all three parts have to be over the timeline. And you're talking the ball and both of the offensive players' feet. In that case, Morris had 1 foot in the backcourt, so it's not a back violation.
Good job by the officials to get together and get it right as Yagant gets a steal. But this is what tends to happen to teams in this building. It all starts to snowball quickly with that crowd behind this team. Finney-Smith. Georgia 2-0 in SEC play for the first time since the 2001-2002 season. Already snapped one long home winning streak this year. And in Missouri's 26-gamer, now trying to snap Florida's 24-game home winning streak.
Once again, Georgia goes to under 10 on the shot clock.
Morris traveled. What's this a result of if you're taking so long?
I think, A, they want to run good offense to slow the game down. They want a slower pace than Florida does, so they're going to run good offense. But I think, and Mark Fox said this earlier today, they can't be tentative. They can't be hesitant. You have to go on the road, and if you're going to make an error, make it on the side of aggression.
Wilbekin for three.
Got it. We know this isn't a great three-point shooting team that Florida has outside of Michael Frazier. But when Scotty Wilbekin's making threes, it makes things so much easier for the guys inside.
Well, tomorrow, conference rivals colliding on ESPNU, 9 o'clock. Two of the best teams in transition in the country, Baylor and Texas Tech, should be a fun game to watch. Followed by Washington and Cal. Both games tomorrow on ESPNU. Juricic wants. This pressure is really getting to the Bulldogs right now. Mark Fox knows it. He takes a timeout. These two teams have met since 1924. Of course, bigger football rivals than they are basketball rivals with their success on the football field. 208th all-time meeting going back to 1924. The only time that they haven't played a home-and-home before this year was in the 1940s. They will not play a game in Athens this season. Billy Donovan is on his way to his 16th consecutive 20-win season. The third winningest coach in SEC history. Dale Brown at LSU, of course, Adolph Rupp at Kentucky, the only guys that have won more games as an SEC coach. For a guy that it seems like just yesterday was a babyface kid that everybody was wondering how he got the job.
It's amazing how he adjusts. Florida averages only 5.7 threes per game, fewest in Billy's 18 years of Florida.
His Gators on a 13-0 run. George has gone more than 5 minutes without a field goal. Here's a get with a size advantage facing a guard in Charles Mann. Parker got his hand on the exit pass, and Georgia with numbers.
Look at Scotty Wilbekin all over the basketball. Scotty Wilbekin is like the honey badger of SEC basketball. He pressures, he gets deflections, he gets steals. He is a tenacious defender.
Marcus Thornton works inside with a double coming. They'll call a tie-up and they'll send it to Florida. Georgia trying to get some semblance of half-court offense.
Well, you're trying to get the basketball on the block, which I like, but Marcus Thornton's going to have to move quicker before Florida doubles down onto the post. And same thing with Georgia. They're not a great three-point shooting team. And what big guys need on the interior is space to operate. And three-point shooters provide that space because they stretch the defense.
Georgia's turned it over four consecutive possessions.
No flash photography. Thank you.
Pulled up right now. The ball was wet, so they had to wipe that off. Casey Hill brings it up.
And we're seeing 1-2-2 zone by Georgia.
Dorian Finney-Smith. Now Casey Hill.
And you know why Georgia goes zone? Because Frazier's not in the game right now.
Wilbekin is, though. Good job by Parker to close out. Force a short shot. Georgia's got to be able to capitalize in these situations in transition, and they do with Cameron Forte.
Great call by Mark Fox. He sees Michael Frazier isn't in the game. They're one three-point shooter. He goes zone. A desperation three under five on the clock. Good run out for Georgia.
Now, when the half-court offense has been as stagnant as it has, they're going to have to get some points in fast break.
Absolutely. That's one way you get easy baskets. Fast break points, second shot opportunities.
Florida having a bit of a difficulty against this Georgia zone in the first two possessions. Wilbekin given space. Finney-Smith given more for three. That's actually Devon Walker with its first three of the game.
That's a good sign for Devon Walker because he goes 0 for 4 on Saturday.
Nimi Jurisic dribbles the ball up for Georgia. Here's Parker in the paint. He'll go to the line for a couple of shots.
Florida foul is on
Florida, who's not a great three-point shooting team this year, has been shooting pretty well today.
They are. We're seeing Finney-Smith hit threes, Wilbekin with the three. They take them when they need to.
Tonight's game is part of My Home Court Week, our week-long celebration of the great college basketball arenas and venues around the country. This is no doubt one of them. And number 7, Florida, shooting the lights out to begin this game. Pleasing that guy with a moose hat on. 4 threes already for Florida.
Like we talked about, some guys need to take them early in the clock. Frazier, as we saw, is an early shot clock three-point attempter. Same thing with Dorian Finney-Smith. But Wilbekin and this guy right here, Devon Walker, late shot clock three-point attempter.
Now, Florida, typically, you think of Florida teams under Billy Donovan, you think of teams that shoot it pretty well, but this group averages less than 6 threes a contest. It's the fewest threes per game in Billy Donovan's 18 years as head coach.
And I think this is Billy's poorest three-point shooting team, despite having a high percentage. They only have one true three-point shooter in Michael Frazier. But I also think this is his hardest playing team. I think Florida has a bunch of role players, Joe, that play their roles extremely well.
Here's Juwan Parker. Now, Georgia shot 44 free throws against Alabama on Saturday. That's their first one tonight.
How about Georgia? They make 4 field goals in the second half against Alabama and go 23 for 34 from the free throw line.
Right. 19% from the field.
When someone says they made four field goals in the entire second half and won, the free throw line is wide.
1 by 8 wasn't even that close. Boy, Alabama having some issues scoring.
They're laboring to score right now. And you thought playing Alabama for Florida, for Georgia, would help prepare them for this game. Why? Anthony Grant, Billy Donovan, former assistant, they press like Florida presses. So you thought that game Saturday would prepare them well for pressure today.
You get with a soft finish. During shoot-around today, Billy Donovan kept on saying, you can't get bored in the half court against this Georgia team. You get again.
And that's a nice move out of a 6'8 guy.
Already 6 for you get, which is more than his season average. Down the floor more for his defense, which leads to this offense.
He is a wonderful press player at the four because he can cover ground. And how about this little crossover Euro?
Yeah,
out of the big fella
out of France. 8 Georgia turnovers leading to half of Florida's points so far. Bulldogs need somebody to hit a shot. Gaines will try. Way off the mark.
Despite the miss, Joe, good offense. They trap. It was the second pass out of the trap, and Gaines had a good look.
Frazier with the reverse. It's getting away from Georgia right now. Timeout, Mark Fox.
When Michael Frazier, who we know is a great three-point shooter, when he starts taking the ball to the basket and finishing at the rim, he is really expanding his offensive game. Because you know he can shoot it. Guys are really going to press up on him. A wonderful finish. Use the rim as a protector. Great move by Michael Frazier.
Dino, ESPN's Journey to the Tourney. A season-long spotlight on games that will impact the tournament. On Saturday, the journey continues. Head to Madison. Sam Decker and the unbeaten Badgers host the Big Ten rival Michigan, which has won 5 straight now. ESPN's Journey to the Tourney. Michigan and Wisconsin, Saturday, 6 o'clock on ESPN. You got to figure it's hard to make a case for anybody else as the best conference in the country.
I think the Big Ten is the best conference in America. When you look at the teams in that league, I just think from top to bottom, they're really, really strong. Some other conferences, the lower end of the league, those teams are weaker. Big Ten, pretty good top to bottom.
Wilbekin comes and guards Morris, who gets rid of it to Mann. Florida on a 22-4 run. Georgia has 1 field goal over the last 9+. Gaines into traffic. Thornton got the rebound and got fouled. Florida is one of the best teams at defending the paint in the entire country. It's only 3 major conference teams that give up fewer points in the paint than the Gators.
I was really impressed with them in practice yesterday. They stretched, and then the entire next hour, all defense, guarding ball screens, guarding dribble handoffs. This is a really strong defensive team.
Thornton, not a very good foul shooter.
Talked to Coach Donovan today, Joe, like he told us. Scotty Wilbekin, a senior point guard. And because of the injury to Prather, he puts Casey Hill at the 1, and Wilbekin doesn't bat an eye. This is what's best for the team, Coach. I'll go to the 2. That's one of the reasons why this team's number 7 in the country. Wonderful team chemistry.
Good veteran leadership. 4 seniors on this Florida roster. Good balance, too. 5 players averaging in double figures. Patrick Young is one of them.
You know he loves to go left shoulder, jump hook. Patrick Young could be Jimmy Graham at the next level in the NFL. That body he has. Amazing.
Antonio Gates, another former basketball player, who didn't actually play a snap of football in college.
Nor did Jimmy Graham in Miami.
I think Gates was recruited to Michigan State to play both, but Nick Saban wanted him to just play football, so he transferred to a couple other places before winding up at Kent State. Young again. Force that one up. Long rebound tracked down by Huguette.
Florida just plays so hard. Also on the offensive end as well. They cut hard. They screen hard.
Billy Donovan didn't love that shot from Will Huguette. He's now 3 of 9 from outside this year. Amy Juricic dribbling down the floor. Offensive foul. Juricic whistled for his first.
The big guy in the open court, and Juricic has a good skill set.
His first, second team foul.
Patrick Young was waiting there before Juricic got off the bus. He was set for a week.
Number 10, Dorian Finney-Smith.
That's what the press does. It makes you play faster than you want to play.
That was one thing Billy Donovan thought that Georgia had done well in the two SEC wins coming in is control the tempo. Frazier. And the face couldn't hit, but the tip out to Wilbekin nearly saved the possession. It's over to Georgia.
And like you mentioned, Kenny Gaines, wonderful defense on the contest.
More pressure. Wilbekin to Finney-Smith.
The Honey Badger with the steal.
And another timeout for Coach Fox, who says settle down, but it's getting away from Georgia.
30 seconds, timeout,
Scotty Wilbekin, wonderful anticipation, cat quick hands. He reminds me a lot on the ball of Aaron Kraft. Quick feet, strong hands. You can't turn your back and try to spin dribble against the double team. Great atmosphere in here tonight.
Rowdy Reptiles in here 2 hours before tip.
We walk into the building at 5 o'clock and the students are here packed and making noise.
Patrick Young Fields. So that relentless pressure from Florida stays on with a 20-point lead, under 5 in this first half. Georgia right now just wanted to get to the locker room. Out of the noise, out of this pressure.
When you're being trapped, it's the second pass out of the trap that'll get you a good shot.
Mann with a nice take. He's third in the SEC in free throws. Because he's so good at putting the ball in the floor and getting to the body.
He really attacks your body when he drives, and he drives the basketball. And Charles Mann, probably Georgia's most indispensable player. He leads them in points. He leads them in assists. He leads them in minutes.
Shot 18 free throws against Alabama Saturday. Made 13.
AC Hill.
Up to 22 points. Wilbekin takes a seat. Casey Hill comes in. SEC Player of the Week with 40 points in the two games on this week combined.
Now, if you're Mark Fox in Georgia, you're just trying to put something together before the half. Let's see if we can get a stop, a score, and then a stop to make a little bit of a run coming off those free throws. Can't leave him.
Frazier's been patient. Frazier around a Young screen with a pick and roll. And Young crumble to the floor. Georgia with numbers. Gains a pull-up. A fight for the rebound. Possession keeps it on this end of the floor.
On the alternating possession, Georgia basketball.
And down the other end, wonderful ball screen defense by Georgia. Good jump hook by Patrick Young. You have to know scouting report. He loves to go jump hook over his left shoulder.
If there's a future. Anish Shroff in the studio coming up at halftime. Wisconsin is at Indiana. The Badgers look to make it 13 straight over the Hoosiers. A good one in the Big 12. Oklahoma visiting Kansas State. And Adrian Branch will tell you how wide open the ACC is. Joe?
All right, Anish. Back here in Gainesville where Florida's opened it up against Georgia. Trying to win their 25th consecutive game on this floor as we dive inside the play.
Very good ball screen defense by Georgia. And we would always tell our guys, five guys must guard the ball screen. So on the roll, look at Georgia's support in the lane. Wonderful ball screen defense by Mark Fox's Georgia Bulldogs.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to the Stephen C. O'Connor.
You want to make that big guy work in a crowd when he rolls to the basket. Make him kick it out.
Georgia will inbound with a fresh shot clock. Coach, last 19 possessions for the Bulldogs, they've gotten up six shots.
Turnovers hurting them. Well, the way you get easy baskets is we talked about fast break and second shot opportunities. And if those things aren't there, then execute your offense in the half court. Execute your way through trouble. Don't try to shoot your way out of trouble.
Parker tries to and rips it. Just like you said, right, Coach?
Parker said, I got this.
You get having a good game with the offensive end. He's got eight.
But that can't happen. You labor and work for an open three in the corner, and they get a transition basket.
You get leads all scores of those 8 points on the floor for his defense. A lot of those points, though, coming from his defense. Parker again to the rim, lays it in. A couple of good possessions for the freshman out of Tulsa, Oklahoma. Only freshman part of this Georgia rotation. Jenny Smith. Good hustle, but saved it to Mann. Charles Mann with an offensive foul.
Georgia foul is number four.
His first, only the third on Georgia.
His first.
Tough call for Georgia.
That's what he does.
That's what he does. And he likes to attack your body on the drive. He's strong enough to absorb the contact and finish what they call the charge on that one.
More than 100 free throws shot by Mann this year. Third most in the SEC, largely because he kind of sticks his head down and gets inside like that. Freedom of movement emphasis here, favoring the offensive player. More often than not, Jacob Perch, former manager on the basketball team, with a chance for a three-point play.
And you just can't play this game with your body. You have to play with your mind. And Jacob Kurtz is on the weak side of the floor. And as soon as he sees Brandon Morris lose vision of him, great cut to the basket, great finish.
Found him up in the stadium watching practice a couple of years ago. Had him come down after a couple managers quit. Then had walk-on tryouts. He was the best one there. Gave him the spot on the team.
They said he was the best one by far.
Florida in transition. Finney Smith the again.
And you're seeing another reason why Florida's number seven in the country. The basketball finds the open man.
And I know they've got two losses, so there's a reason for it. But I think number seven's low for this team.
And think about when they get healthy and whole. Their leading scorer and arguably best player isn't out here tonight.
And Casey Prather, 17 points a game. He missed a chunk of last season because of injuries. Only averaging 3 points a game over his first 3 years. Probably the most improved player in the country. But out with an injury.
And I think the reason for that, it has taken Casey Prather 3 years to play to his strengths. He figured it out. Early in his career, he was trying to prove everybody wrong by taking jump shots, saying, hey, I am a jump shooter. I can make these. But now he's running, getting to the glass, getting to the free throw line, Casey Prather. And that's why he's leading this team in scoring.
Thornton. Is from point blank. Young with the rebound. Florida looks to run with a 20-point lead here in the first half. Hill thought about a three, instead drives. And when you play this well without a guy, that allows you the opportunity to wait a little longer before you bring him back. You don't have to rush to bring a guy before he's ready.
Absolutely. Now, Georgia will get 2-for-1 before the end of the half if they play their cards right.
His man, tough take, couldn't finish. You get the only one that went to save the ball. Wilbick in the kick. Frazier the three. And a bit of a rough shooting night for the SEC's top outside shooter, who's passed up several open looks.
But that's a great one for Florida.
Last touch by Georgia. Inside of a minute in this first half, Kurtz comes back in. Florida will have it.
Now, of course, anybody that has to foul, the coaches want to protect, now's the time to get them out. Especially for Georgia on the defensive end.
Also for Georgia, number 30, J.J. Frazier.
Nobody with two for Georgia. Anthony Smith and Walker both with two for Florida. Less than a minute left in this first half. A couple of teams off the 2-0 starts.
Coach Donovan has a timeout. If he wants to burn, if he doesn't use it, he'll lose it going into the second half.
Frazier runs the baseline, pops out on the other side, defended by J.J. Frazier. Shot clock inside of 10. Wilbekin sizes up Parker, gets fouled on the drive, only the fifth by Georgia, but it'll reset the shot clock and turn it off with 23 seconds.
I love the students and their knowledge of the game. When the shot clock's winding down, they're calling it down for the Florida kids. And when I first got to Wake Forest, Joe, and the shot clock is winding down, it was dead silence. I sent a university email to all the students, help us out, count it down for us.
Things have been pretty easy for Florida the last couple of minutes as they've extended this lead to 20. It's all been a product of the pressure on defense.
It really has. They're trapping, getting good traps. A wonderful cut by Kurt when Brandon Morris turned his head. And watch how the ball moves. Both of those guys had a good shot. The layup was a better shot. So they moved the basketball.
It's a Florida team that's 13-2 despite dealing with injuries and suspensions and off to a perfect start in SEC play. You've got two teams everybody expected, two teams nobody expected, but at least through one additional game, the cream kind of rising to the top.
I think on January 14th, Florida is the best team in this league. Now, that other one there, number 13, with the K in front of it.
How about March 14th?
Yeah, they might be, because they are the most talented. And once Coach Cal gets those guys understanding how he wants them to play, but I think right now this is the best team in the Southeast Conference.
So Florida can have the final shot of the half if they want it. And just barely will have a shot at it. Wilbekin nearly lost it into the backcourt. What an opening half for the Gators, trying to win their seventh in a row and their 25th straight in this building. Wilbekin with the clock inside of 10, around a double screen. The kick to Frazier, who leans into Jurisic and leaves it short to bring this first half to a close. Willie again, a senior who's on the floor mostly for his defense, leads all scorers with 10. And Florida leads Georgia by 20. Let's send it to the studio now for our halftime report. Here's an East Rock. On ESPN and back inside the O'Connell Center in Gainesville, Florida, where Florida is well on its way, it looks like, to winning the 25th consecutive game in this building, which would be a new school record. Back inside this raucous atmosphere, back court side. Dino Gaudio, former ACC coach, Joe Davis. I said it earlier, I don't know if number seven's high enough. What is it that Florida's doing so well?
Their defense, and in particular their pressure defense, has been terrific. They're turning Georgia over. And the other thing they're doing is they're guarding without fouling. Georgia comes into the game in two SEC games, having attempted 73 throws, 35 a game. Georgia has 6 free throws. So Florida is guarding without fouling.
Here's some of that press leading to offense.
And it's energy. One of the things in the press is not giving up, chasing the ball from behind. You get does that. And you cannot spin dribble against pressure, still by Wilbekin. And you love Florida. We talk about pressure. They play pressure on offense, too. They attack you with the fast break. And guys love to play when the ball's moving. And as you saw, the ball moves for Florida.
Dino, Manning Gaines combined for 44 on Saturday against Alabama. They didn't make a field goal in the first half, just 1 point between the two of them. And then that defense for Florida leading to 12 turnovers, which led to 16 points off of those turnovers.
How about Georgia in their last total of 40 minutes? They had 4 field goals in the last 4 minutes against Alabama, and they have 6 in the first half here. 10 made baskets in 40 minutes. For Georgia.
Yeah, they led 6-4. The 15:35 mark did the Bulldogs. Then over the next 10 plus, Florida went on a 26-4 run. 10 turnovers, 6 made field goals during that stretch for the Bulldogs. Here's your gap. Florida pacing on this opening possession, a half number two. Inside to Patrick Young. He's got 6.
He's developing a very soft touch. And defensively, KYP, know your personnel. The scouting report says Patrick likes to go over his left shoulder. Take that away from him. Look at Patrick Young, number 4, with the SEC logo. He's sagging in the lane because Marcus Thornton is not a scoring threat from the outside.
Thornton with the shot clock winding down off the front of the rim. Rebound for Frazier. That one hit the net. Still found Wilbekin. Got fouled by Dante Williams, his second, first one of the half.
And I like Casey Hill, the way he throws. He keeps his dribble alive. Wonderful shot fake by Scotty Wilbekin.
The second half against Georgia.
The best fake you can incorporate in the game is the shot fake. Why? It makes the defense unathletic. You're standing straight up, and you're able to go by them. This guy right here, 8 straight games in double figures.
9 of 10 total this year. Didn't even practice leading up to the Arkansas game because of an ankle injury suffered against South Carolina here last week. Wound up playing 34 minutes in that game and matching a career high with 18. Wilbekin will check out. Devon Walker comes in after a late whistle there. Free throw.
Looked like he was injured. That's why the official Rick Hartzell stopped the play.
Morris goes behind his back with Walker right on top of him. Now Gaines, Thornton. He'll shoot two.
Yeah, Wilbekin, he shot the second free throw, Joe, missed it, but looks like his leg's bothering him again.
Injuries have been a big issue for this team.
He's just telling Billy right now, looks like he might have bumped knees. How about the trainer, Dave Werner? He is earning his pay this year with the Florida Gators.
You got Wilbekin, their second leading scorer, been dealing with an ankle. Of course, Casey Prather, their leading scorer, is out tonight with a bruised knee. Casey Hill missed time earlier this year with an ankle injury. Frazier's had issues with his calves. Of course, Young has been banged up for most of his career with tendonitis.
That's why, like we said at the onset, and still Donovan has his team number 7 in the country, and they might be higher. They might be a better team than number 7.
Frazier thought about it. SEC's top three-point shooter was just one of five from outside in the first half. Shot clock down to five, and you get the go to the line for two shots. He's been a different guy in the offensive end tonight.
He really has. He's been very, very aggressive. And when he was injured last year, that four-man position on the press is so very important. He has to be careful of trying to do too much on the offensive end, but he is the ultimate four-man power forward press player, Joe. When we were at Xavier, we had some really good guys that were on the ball that were able to press. And that's what this guy does. He chases balls down. He can guard a point guard if necessary.
And the Juricic into the game. He's the only guy that has started all 16 games now for Billy Donovan.
He's an energy guy. He's a guy when he walks in the room, the energy level steps up.
Yeah, with a season high 12. He'll check out after making the free throw. Dorian Finney-Smith back in. And that press still on for Florida, keeping the pressure on, up 22.
Anytime you see the double team or the trap, pass fake. Fake a pass to make a pass.
And then you say the second pass out of it?
Yeah, the second pass out of the trap will get you the shot.
Got 2 seconds. Get it over just in time. Thornton over Young plus the foul.
I like the way Marcus Thornton's playing on the interior. He's playing big. He's taking the ball to the floor to big guys. He's playing with some aggressiveness on the interior. When you're going up against shot blockers, you fade away. That's when they block shots. Take the ball right to a shot blocker's chin.
Young just picked up his third foul.
And here comes our guy, Wilbekin. He must have been just bumped knees, it looked like.
So Wilbekin back in. Walker, Frazier, you get Finney Smith for the Gators. So a three-point play from Marcus Thornton. He's got seven now.
If you're Mark Fox, you're telling you guys, don't watch the score. Don't look at the score. Let's just do what we're supposed to do. Let's execute against the press, and let's execute in the half court with respect to our offense.
Ten to shoot. You get screen and roll. Wilbekin into a crowd. Finney Smith the three. Transfer from Virginia Tech. 8 points total for him now. Georgia able to break the press effectively this time. Tipped out of bounds, last touch by Florida.
And I really like Florida's ball screen defense as well. Guy rotating from the weak side of the defense to take the roll guy. Now the inbounds comes in with 13, and we have 10 on the clock right now.
Gaines launches way too strong. Boy, he's having a tough game, one game after his career high 22. Gaines 0-4 from the field, still looking for his first points.
You know what, Joe? He's a 28% three-point shooter. Now, he was 4-for-7 from threes against Alabama. But with the clock coming down 8-7, his strength is driving the ball. That's what he should do. Put foul pressure on the Florida guards.
You got a good spot for the moving screen of his first. And the third Florida foul of his first half.
Now here's the handoff. I don't know about that. Looks like he was set.
Yeah.
I think it looked worse because
he's
part of being a good player is being a good actor. Have an act. Uh-huh.
being big and strong doesn't hurt either.
No.
Probably made the impact look a little worse than it was. Parker able to save it to Jurisic. Georgia trying to find something on offense. Going to Morris, who uses that pivot foot. And Thornton follows it with a tip to
Marcus Thornton.
Marcus Thornton now with 9 to lead Georgia. But Frazier's passed up several open looks today.
He has, and I'm not sure why. He's a little deeper out on the floor. He needs to get closer to the line when the ball's in the air. He needs to do his work a little earlier.
Tend to shoot. Finney Smith with a kick. Wilbekin tries to go by Thornton in the same spot that he sent the game into overtime against Arkansas on Saturday off the back iron.
And he has that little step back which creates the space for himself like he did against Arkansas, but he just couldn't finish the shot right there.
Picked the right spot to hit that shot. You take hitting it on Saturday versus here in a 20-point game. Mann scores in a foul. And Georgia's kept on fighting this one.
I like it, and I like the call, too.
A chance for a three-point play for Charles Mann on the other side. It's Patrick Young Beard Night. Everybody's wearing one. We'll talk more about it when we come back. This is all part of ESPN's My Home Court Week, and Florida dominated on its home floor. A Patrick Young Beard Night. We gave those orange beards to the first 1,000 students that came, and those 1,000 were here about 2 hours before the game. He looks a little better than we did. Pulls off the orange beard. The Florida gymnastics team all rocking them. Chris Prather.
I think Casey could flex him a little bit there for us with the bicep.
An SEC network analyst, Tim Tebow. You know what I didn't like about him, though? It might have been because we had the headset on. But those orange hairs aren't glued on there very well. I'm
exactly.
Still picking them out of my mouth after putting it on.
Mark Fox really liked this young guy, Charles Mann. 6'5", 210, point guard. He has size, he has strength. He's not playing great tonight. 5 turnovers for him, but a bright future for Georgia.
Wide open in the corner, Finney Smith.
As he created the open shot, despite him missing, was the curl by Wilbekin getting into the lane.
Jurisic misses his first attempt from three. If he had enough attempts, Jurisic, that is, he'd be the leader in the SEC, above 50% of the season.
When coaches talk about spacing, you know what creates spacing? Four men that can shoot the ball, like Jurisic. Same action for Florida. Wilbekin on the curl.
This time he draws contact. Foul goes on Juwan Parker, his first. Fourth on Georgia. Eric Murphy, former Florida Gator, in the house tonight.
And you talk about spacing. That guy created spacing for you. He was a pick-and-pop four-man that could screen and then step out. And we'll talk further about it, but it's amazing how Billy Donovan has adjusted his ball screen offense according to his personnel.
And he's done it time and time again over these couple decades.
He really has. And, you know, early in 06 and 07 when they won national championships, that was a pick-and-roll team. Al Horford, Joakim Noah were rollers to the basket. And then you've seen a guy like Bonner and Eric Murphy are pick-and-pop guys. And he has a team now that you get and Young are roll guys to the basket. But Dorian Finney-Smith has the potential to pick and pop as well.
They talk about good coaching is knowing how to adjust. That's not just within a game or within a season, but that's across years.
Absolutely. And nobody's done it better than that guy on the sideline. The only active coach right now under 50 with a national championship.
He's got a couple, 06 and 07.
Parker, good shot fake, but got blocked by Walker. Last touch by Georgia. Oh, it's your chance to get an inside look at some of college football's most talented draft-eligible players. They fine-tune for the NFLPA Collegiate Bowl. The NFLPA Collegiate Bowl practices presented by Panini. That's on TV tomorrow and on Thursday, 1 and 4 o'clock on ESPNU and live on Watch ESPN. Frazier will take this open look. He's now 1 for 6 from three.
Another good look for him, and Billy Donovan's happy with the shot.
Juricic. Foul on the rebound. Goes on Florida. It goes on Yegette, who just picked up his third, and the sixth Florida foul of his second half.
I'm taking that foul if I'm Florida. I want my guys boxing up, putting their tails, their back ends in there, and driving guys out.
Actually say the foul came on the shot, so Juricic will shoot two free throws.
I saw Teddy Valentine, like, here's his description, put his back end in there. He must have felt that he moved him from underneath on the shot. Okay.
Thornton out, Dante Williams in.
Substitution for Florida, number 30.
Georgia's three leading scorers, coach, on the season. Average combined, we're talking man gains and Juricic, who just got his first point. They averaged 35 points a game tonight. They've combined for four, now five.
You have two guys on this Georgia team, Brandon Morris and Dante Williams, both from Miller Grove High School in Atlanta. Charmin White, the coach there at Miller Grove, five straight state championships. How about the front court at Miller Grove a couple years ago, Joe? Brandon Morris, we're seeing here, Dante Williams, and then Tony Parker, that's at UCLA. Huh. How about that high school front line?
Yeah.
I worked with Coach White at the Nike Skills Academy 2 years ago. A wonderful teacher. And you see the product of his teaching, his pupils, two of them right here.
Good feet by Juricic to stay with Frazier. Here's Gaines in transition. That's where Georgia, we knew, would have to be able to capitalize, but they've just not had many opportunities to, because Florida's only turned the ball over five times. Not missed many shots either. Casey Hill called for the foul, his second. That's the sixth. The Gators.
Now, at your mark, Fox, you want you guys to finish the game strong. Hey, we've gotten off to a great start this season. A nice win on the road at, like I said, at the time, number 21 Missouri. They beat a good Alabama team at home. You know it's going to be tough coming into Florida, but you want your guys to finish the game the right way.
Gaines with his first 2 points tonight, second leading scorer for this team, averages more than 12. Coming off a career-high 22 with Florida, one of the nation's top teams on the defensive end, has shut him and his teammates down.
And how about Brandon Morris's versatility? Here he is at 6'8", guarding a point guard, Casey Hill.
31 in black, top of your screen. Here's Hill now, defended by Morris. He sees that, tries to beat him off of the bounce, and got fouled by help defense. Goes on Parker to second, the third on Georgia. Coach Gaudio will break down Georgia's basic offense for us, which will try to get going. Down 16, we come back. Georgia hasn't turned it over in the second half. They've chipped it down to 16. As far as them on the offensive end of the floor, they've not been great tonight, but take us inside exactly what they're trying to do with their basic offense.
Fox's Georgia Bulldogs run what they call their basic offense, and you're going to see the pass to the top and then the cutter on the baseline, Brandon Morris. That's a flex cut. And it's a good screen here by Thornton, which creates the opening for the shot. And if Morris wasn't open, you'd see number two there duck in. And here it is again. The first option of the basic offense, the pass, the flex cut. And Joe, it had its origins in Judd Heathcote ran it at Michigan State. Mike Montgomery was his assistant. And then Trent Johnson, of course, was Coach Montgomery's assistant.
And then Mark Fox worked for Trent at Nevada. So all of those guys running the basic offense, and that's the coaching tree, started with Judd Heat's coach at Michigan State.
Why hasn't that worked more tonight?
I just think there's so much pressure by Florida, not just in the full court, in the half court.
And you know this as a quarterback.
Yeah.
When they're pressuring the passer and you're in the pocket and they're coming after you.
Not comfy.
It's not comfortable. It's difficult to make that pass. That's exactly what Florida has done in the half court on defense.
Casey Hill with an 0 of 2 at the stripe.
A plus for Georgia, 12 turnovers at halftime. 12 turnovers still with 11:45 to play in the second half.
And within 16, and they need to hit some shots, but still hanging in there. There's Thornton for two more, leading the Dogs now with 11.
Now, Florida came out zone that possession, and Georgia handled it incredibly well.
Hill with the extra pass to Wilbekin, who thought about pulling the trigger, but then thought better of it. Here's Finney Smith, turning it over.
But he played outstanding, as we know, against Arkansas. He was just spectacular in that game. And how about if our colleague Seth Greenberg is at Virginia Tech? Dorian Finney-Smith in the lineup. He had Jarrell Eddy there. The big fella Montrezl Harrell helps Louisville win a national championship. With the ACC down a little bit, Virginia Tech would be right there with Syracuse at the top of that league.
Forte can't hit. Rebound Young. Hill so quick with the ball in his hands. Draws the attention of the defense and gets it back from Wilbekin.
You're saying they're not a great three-point shooting team by any means. And now their three-point shooter tonight, Michael Frazier, isn't scoring from behind the line either.
Here's Gaines. In and out. Tip won't go. Last touch by Georgia. Well, tomorrow, conference rivals meeting up on ESPNU, 9 o'clock. Baylor looks to make it 20 of 21 against in-state competition. They take on Texas Tech. And then a Pac-12 battle between Washington, coming off a big win over Colorado, and a Cal team that's won 3 road games to begin conference play. 9 o'clock and then 11 tomorrow on ESPNU. Von Walker goes by Forte. Young, a strong rebound. Opening up Frazier, who can't seem to find the mark from three. 1 of 7 for the SEC's top three-point shooter. Here's Gaines. And Georgia continues to miss point blank with a chance to get back into this game. Frazier gets fouled. Mann gets called his second.
Mark Fox is deciding.
Oh. The last two shots, right at the cup, right at the basket.
Should be a 10-point game right now.
No question.
Wilbekin getting looked at again. He did not start on Saturday after injuring his ankle against South Carolina midway through last week.
The first time he went out, it looked like when Coach Donovan walked over there, he was rubbing his knee and pointing to his knee. But
Frazier, Florida's top free throw shooter, snaps a 6-0 run. Georgia, which very well could be an 8 or 10 or 12-0 run. But instead, Florida has it back to 15 with one more coming for Frazier.
Michael Frazier comes into the game. He's not shooting well today. 48% from behind the three-point line, which is third best in the NCAA. He's 48 from behind the three-point line. The rest of Florida coming in tonight, a combined 29% from behind the stripe.
Not the typical Billy Donovan team. Actually, all the guys that can shoot it. Juricic with an extra pass to Thornton. And he misses from point blank. And Juricic hit. A whistle. And a foul on Casey Hill, his third. My goodness, how frustrating is this for Georgia?
And two of those misses were from their big guys. They have to play through contact.
It looks like maybe a groin or a hip flexor, a quad. They're working on both legs.
It almost looks like they're stretching his hip out the way they're working him there.
Timeout, Florida Gators. Timeout.
Timeout taken by Billy Donovan, whose team is holding on to this lead against Georgia, trying to get the 3-0 SEC play. Off the floor from the 2006 Final Four in Indianapolis, brought it back here to the O'Connell Center. It is now the home floor for the Gators. They sanded it down, so put their own paint on it. Did you teach Joe Kim Noah those dance moves?
No. I honestly think, Joe, I'm better than that.
Well, it's not tough.
Well, I don't know what that was. This is what it looks like now after they've sanded it down and put their own design on one of the great arenas in the country, part of my home court week here on ESPN. Joe Davis, Dino Gaudio back in Gainesville. One more coming for Nimi Juricic. Florida hasn't hit a field goal since the 17-15 mark. Missed seven shots in a row as Frazier nearly turns it over. Young nearly gets fouled, and now does. Marcus Thornton. First down Thornton. Sixth Georgia foul of the second half.
It's been a little bit of a frustration foul. But those two big guys been banging all evening long, and Marcus Thornton wasn't let, allowing Patrick Young to get his arms above his shoulders. Florida's 50th 1,000 points scored. Yeah. Patrick Young.
More than 700 rebounds in his career, too.
And like he said, he could be a great NFL tight end. Or what is it, mixed martial arts? Put him in the cage there.
MMA? I wouldn't go in there with him.
No way.
He might win on forfeits enough to have a decent record.
He can have the orange beard on. I still wouldn't go in there with him.
The baseline. Takes a look at the shot clock. 10 to shoot. Juricic can shoot it from out there. Instead throws it away.
Florida basketball.
We see Georgia's not playing well, not to the liking of that guy right there, but Florida's defense, very, very good team. They're into the ball, they're pressuring passers. This is as good a defensive performance I've seen all season.
The rebound tips to Walker, who finds Frazier.
You know what we would tell guys? If you can't grab the offensive rebound, keep it alive. And that's exactly what the Florida big guys did.
Foul on the floor goes on man. Puts Florida into the bonus, so 1-1 coming here for Patrick Young.
Florida will shoot the bonus.
This Florida team ranked number 7 right now. You say right now best team in the SEC. Might not be the case 2 months from now.
At the line.
Bottom line, though, SEC as far as this year versus last year, what do you think?
I think it's better. I think this league can get 5 teams. You know, we're talking Kentucky, we're talking Florida, we're talking Tennessee, LSU, probably Missouri in the NCAA tournament. And you know, Joe, Mark Whitworth, the associate commissioner, has the basketball side of this conference heading in a great direction. Major emphasis is placed on non-league scheduling. The conference actually hired Greg Shaheen as a consultant. And Greg Shaheen spent 12 years with the NCAA selection committee. And now the SEC teams in the spring and early summer have to submit their schedules, their non-league schedules, for review by the league office to make sure they're positioning themselves when NCAA tournament time rolls around.
Which is a new thing, so you'll really see the impact of that moving forward in the years to come. Florida by 17 here in Gainesville. Yeah, the 24 remaining unbeaten as Syracuse coming from behind to remain that way last night. Back here in Gainesville, Patrick Young, beard night. They've got a tape for the big guy, Billy Donovan. Well, Florida has gone 9-20 without a field goal, but because Georgia has struggled to convert on the offensive end, still a comfortable lead.
And it's because of Florida's defense. Now, fellas, if they don't score, obviously with the lead we have, they can't just keep guarding. If the ball falls for us, fine. If not, we're just going to keep defending on with respect to Georgia's offense, and they're doing that.
Three to shoot. Gaines gets a little bit of space. Forte, a strong rebound. He goes back up in traffic and misses off the side of the rim. Frazier, finally whips in.
Only a matter of time. You love his stroke. It's almost perfect. He just has the ball a little bit in front of his head, but I'd take that kid any day.
2 for 9 from outside now for the SEC's top three-point shooter.
The Honey Badgers, Wilbekin heading to the table again to check in.
Thornton. Frazier again. He said it was only a matter of time.
Nice.
And a timeout taken by Georgia.
Great ball movement by Florida. Steps right into the shot. And the hardest three to guard is the transition three. Georgia does not get out in conversion defense. When he hit that second one, the whole bench, when Georgia called timeout, ran onto the floor. This young guy is really well-liked by his teammates and the coaching staff as well.
Spent the summer playing for Billy Donovan in the U19 U.S. FIBA World Championship team. Net got tied up.
Chris Walker helping him cut the nets down there, straight net out. He'll be doing a lot more than that when he becomes eligible.
Yeah, one of the top incoming freshmen in the country this past year. Right now working, Florida working with the NCAA to evaluate his eligibility. He's enrolled. He enrolled mid-December. He's practicing with the team. And waiting things out.
He was really good in practice yesterday. High energy guy, runs the floor, can finish at the rim.
How does he change this team if they do get him eligible?
I think he's another athlete that just fits in perfect with the press defense that Bill Donovan runs. He runs the floor well. He can finish at the rim.
You got to find minutes for him. So much talent on this roster. Forte lost it. Walker got it. So Florida has its largest lead. Georgia had cut the lead down to 14, but has missed its last 8 shots as Finney Smith gets fouled. And Marcus Thornton in second.
Offensive rebounding is nothing but effort. And right now, that's what Florida's doing. 2 and 3 looks at the basket. There's no way you can beat them when you're giving them second and third shot opportunities.
Finney Smith, he'll shoot 2 shots.
But when you control that real estate around the rim, and that's offensive rebounds or box out, it's almost like the line play in football. Whoever controls that line of scrimmage, whoever controls the backboard, goes a long way to winning the game.
Florida, one spot they've not been good tonight, is at the line, just 9 of 18. As Finney Smith sits down.
Just an average free throw shooting team at 67% Florida coming into the game. But if they want to make another Elite Eight run, they need to make free throws.
Forte gets blocked by Walker. The defense for Florida, the story tonight.
Because Forte was too low to the baseline. He was literally under the glass in a very tough angle for that shot.
Walker took a shot to the face.
Substitution for Florida, number 0, Casey Hill.
Right under the right eye.
Those are the ones where you walk down and say, let's go. You ready?
Yeah.
Right. Get back in there.
Yeah.
Florida's answer to 6-0 Georgia run with an 11-1 run itself.
At that 13, Young gets into double figures for the fifth consecutive game.
And the reason he's so open, a little guy guard sets a low away screen block to block. And Patrick Young just flashes to the basketball.
For it, pulled out by Gaines. Gaines goes by Young and knocks it down.
Kenny Gaines. That's
Kenny Gaines' game. And he really got better from last year, Joe, because every day in practice, he was going against Contavious Caldwell-Pope, who's a pro, as we know. And going against that kind of competition in practice really helped this young guy improve.
Fraser with a scoring
strike.
Forte looked at Mark Fox on the bench, and Mark Fox just walked right down and is getting a sub in.
Can't give him that much room. Talked about it all shoot around.
I would have guys say, Coach, he's hot. You know what? If he's hot, don't let him catch it. Don't tell me he's hot.
Man. Response.
3-point basket for Charles Mann.
Three for Georgia, a team that's coming off back-to-back. SEC wins. Mark Fox, if you're a Georgia fan, you know the story by now, but lost his father two Saturdays ago. His father, Ray Fox, Kansas, passed away with complications from lung disease. He got the word that his father was sick during the Jordan-Washington game. Flew out there, didn't get there in time. Came back to set a game plan for the Missouri game. Flew with his family and the director of ops to Garden City, Kansas for the funeral. Then drove a van 500 miles to Missouri and pulled off this upset. He said he didn't really have time to think about his emotions as he went through that scramble in the days leading up to the Missouri game. But that game finishes and just kind of let it all out.
It is. He was preparing. They arrived in Columbia, Missouri after the 500-mile drive at 4:30 a.m. He said he never slept, obviously. He went through his father's service and got out prepared, went through the shoot around, pre-game meal, film sessions, and then when it was over, it just hit him. And a great moment that the Georgia kids played so well for him after the trying time that he had gone through. And his dad was a great track coach, great basketball coach. One of the Georgia staff members said, Ray Fox, Mark's dad, said Mark was a better sprinter than he was basketball player.
He played collegiately. Fox,
Eastern New Mexico.
No.
I could see Mark Fox in those starting blocks ready to, when the gun pops, take off.
Yeah.
Not now.
No. Right now, Florida defense has shut down this Georgia team, and it's shut down Georgia's strength, which is their backcourt. These two guys average 26 points a game. They're coming off a game where they combined for 44. And tonight, just 10.
Yeah, when you throw Parker in there, Parker and those two guys did combine for 44 of their 48, counting Parker, of their 58 points against Alabama. But you take away as a coach the known. In other words, what might beat you? It was Mann and Gaines for Georgia. The Florida staff did just that. Little baseline runner action for Michael Fraser offensively.
Hill will try a three and knock it down.
He's not shooting a great percentage, but I like his stroke.
Yeah, only 4 for 21 from outside now. Casey Hill this year, freshman at a Mount Vernon Academy in Florida.
How about that program? Right now sitting at number one in the nation.
Tim Dixon.
In high school basketball. Kevin Sutton started that program, now an assistant at Georgetown. And Kevin Boyle came down from New Jersey and just picked up where Kevin left off.
Fraser with another three. There's another Mount Vernon guy. Dakari Johnson, center at Kentucky, Mount Vernon.
They're sitting at 15-0 right now, number one in the high school polls, Mount Vernon. I had two guys come out of there, L.D. Williams and Gary Clark, and a beautiful campus just outside of Orlando.
Young with a good box out. Talking about high school talent, where these teams go for it as Finney-Smith is open. Another Florida three. 11th of the game for the Gators.
Substitution score for number 25, Devon Walker. And number 30, Jacob Curtis.
Great basketball fans here, and they appreciate good play.
Florida has started to shoot the lights out here in the second half.
We said coming in, this wasn't a great three-point shooting team, but tonight they're proving us wrong, and nobody's done it better than this guy right here, Michael Frazier.
Is Wisconsin trying to remain as one of the four unbeatens? Do you have a favorite out of those four?
I like Arizona. I think they have size. I think T.J. McConnell is a difference maker at the point guard. When they had Mark Lyons, the transfer from Xavier, starting for him, Joe, he was more of a score-first point guard. T.J. McConnell, the exact opposite. A lot of scores on that team. He gets the ball to who has the hot hand.
Diver to the floor, Billy Donovan Jr.
Like his pop.
Yeah. You said you were watching him shoot the other day, and he looks exactly like his dad shooting the ball.
I hope he gets his shot off today. Exactly the same. Started his career at Catholic University in D.C. He was interested in getting into politics, but now his dad said he wants to coach. Came back to Florida. He's going to be a great high school coach if he decides to do it.
A good guy to learn from. Man can't hit the bank shot. Offensive rebound for John Cannon. His first shot won't go. Man with another try. Rolls over the rim.
And Coach Donovan was at Providence, of course, with Rick Pitino. Coach Pitino told him, listen, you can't play next year. You're too heavy. I need you to drop 25 pounds if you want to be on this basketball team. And he did. And as we know, the rest is history.
Parker flushes it down. This is the first Florida game I've done, so the first time I'd seen Florida shoot around. Boy, does Billy Donovan coach his kids every second.
Exactly. I mean, there's no nonsense. He doesn't put up with any lax play.
I mean, it is a shooter. We saw just contrasting styles, and there's no right or wrong way to shoot around. There's different styles from coaches, but to compare it, Georgia finished her shoot around by throwing up half court shots, having fun, a lighter mood. They didn't feel like a shoot around before Florida's team today. They went at it for a little bit.
They really did. He looked like Pops or what?
A little bit, yeah. Same expression as
Steve. And like I said, I hope he gets a shot up because it looks exactly like his dad.
J.J. Frazier.
Billy could play right now. After practice yesterday, he goes, you want to go work out? I go, Billy, I already worked out today. He goes, I'm going in the weight room. He's in the throw an iron around.
Big guy. Barrel-chested guy.
Lex Edwards,
sophomore from Orlando, is in.
And it's great to give these walk-ons an opportunity because those guys do all the dirty work for you. In practice, they're running the scout team. They're invaluable to your team and your team's chemistry.
Donovan just fouled Parker.
Florida finals number 42, Billy Donovan.
His dad biting on his fingernail. I don't know if he's trying to keep himself from getting on him.
Never foul a jump shooter. Never, ever foul a three-point shooter.
Pitt and Georgia Tech follows us. First meeting as ACC opponents for those two teams. It's a 15-1 Pitt squad. Now, without Grant Johnson out for the year with a knee injury. Georgia Tech coming off that win over Notre Dame. Should be a good one to follow us.
And Pittsburgh's a team, almost like this Florida team, when they have fifth-year seniors in Zana and Patterson. Cameron Wright, a fourth-year junior. And as we know, Prather didn't start tonight, but this Florida team can start four seniors. And you have some teams around the country with great young talent, but the teams with the veterans, I think those are the teams that go far in the tournament.
Good point guard play doesn't hurt. They've got two of them. Casey Hill.
1 minute.
Scotty
Wilbekin. 1 minute remaining.
Lex Edwards gets inside and turns it over. Kenny Paul Gino with a bounce for Parker. Nearly got his shot sent out the baseline by Walker. Donovan picks up the foul. Indiana has taken down Wisconsin, so chance for the Gators to maybe jump. We'll see how far Wisconsin falls. Where do you think Florida belongs? Is it at 7? Is that correct? Or, I mean, based on the record, sure, they belong at 7, but where do they rank as far as the best teams in the country?
I think they're set at 7. I don't think this is the best team in the country.
You think it's the 7th best?
Because they don't shoot it great, despite what we saw the last 10 minutes here. And I don't think they have a dominating low post score.
Right.
Patrick Young is good, not great. Yeget is good, not great. A little more suspense for Michigan at Wisconsin on Saturday.
Michigan's won 5 in a row.
The number 4 and number 1 team in the country at not turning the ball over.
Florida will go to Auburn Saturday, a team that, you know, the wins and losses it doesn't show, but it's played really well in the first week of conference play. J.J. Frazier cans a 3.
Good basket for J.J. Frazier.
Still, though, a season low for Georgia in points. As Florida sets a new school record with its 25th consecutive win in the O-Dome. Still 50, the final score. Florida remains unbeaten in SEC play. Georgia suffers its first loss. Appreciate you tuning in. We send it back to the studio now. Tony Strong.